In the previous video, we have looked about the MI of solid sphere, and let's talk about the moment of inertia of a cylinder in different conditions. So in this video, I am offering to you the MI of cylinder around an axis which is perpendicular to its length. So here, MI of cylinder around an axis perpendicular to its length. So in order to find the MI of the cylinder, we can assume that this complete cylinder is made up by a number of discs, as we have also assumed in the case of solid sphere, and now I am assuming the same. Okay, so you can see on the board this cylinder can be cut out into a number of discs. Okay, out of them there is one disc here. So you can easily see that whatever the radius of the cylinder, that will also be radius of the particular disc. Okay, so I am taking this disc AB, having center O dash and having radius R as that of the cylinder. Let us assume that the density of the material of the cylinder is rho, then the density of this particular disc will also be rho, because it is a part of the cylinder. As you can see that I am rotating the cylinder around the axis which is perpendicular to its length. This is the length, this is the length, and if I want to rotate this body around an axis which is perpendicular to its length, so its length is in along the direction of x-axis, then the perpendicular axis will be y-axis, and I am rotating the cylinder in this way, clockwise or anti-clockwise, whatever you like. Okay, then this disc will also be rotate around this particular axis. Okay, so first let me find the moment of inertia of the disc around its diameter, around the diameter of this disc. So diameter of this disc is nothing but OA or dash B. So first I am finding the moment of inertia of the disc around its diameter A or dash B. Okay, so MI of disc around diameter, and what is the name of the diameter? Diameter is A O dash B. Okay, in the last video you can check that the moment of inertia of a disc around any diameter is given by 1 by 4 mass multiplied by radius of the disc. So radius of the disc is R, so it is R square. Now let's talk about the mass of this disc. Let's say the width of the disc is dx. Then what about the mass? Mass is nothing but volume times of density, okay? And volume, what is the volume of the disc? This is a pi r square multiplied by its width. Area multiplied by width gives me the volume. If I multiply this factor with the rho, then this becomes mass of the disc, okay? So pi r square dx by pi r square dx rho is the mass of the disc, and multiply with the r square, this is the mass, this is r square, it is in the form of 1 by 4 m r square, and this is the moment of inertia of the disc around the diameter. But in this case the mass of the disc can be split at as this. Okay, so this is that particular moment of inertia. As I will rotate this complete cylinder in this direction, then this disc will also be rotated. So we need to find the MI of the disc around this axis, okay, which is perpendicular to the length of the cylinder. So to find the MI of the disc around this axis, we can use the theorem of parallel axis. What is the statement of theorem of parallel axis? The moment of inertia of a body is given by, so that is I, let's say this is I dash. The moment of inertia of the body around an axis which is parallel to this axis, so this is this value, this is 1 by 4 pi I square dx rho times of pi square, so this becomes r is the power 4 plus mass multiplied by square of the distance between the two axes. Okay, so what is the mass? of the disk. Again, this is pi r square dx rho, and the distance is square. What about the distance? Distance between two these axes is x, so I am taking as x square. Okay, just adjust these terms. So here we have 1 by 4 pi r to the power 4 rho dx, and here I have pi r square and x square rho dx. Okay, or I can take pi as common, rho as common, and dx as common. So pi rho and r square is also common. So pi rho r square is appearing in all the terms, so I have taken all these values common. So pi rho r square and remaining terms are 1 by 4 r square here, and plus here what is the remaining term? This is x square only, and dx is also common. If you multiply both these terms into the bracket, you will get the same value as it is. So this is the moment of inertia of this particular disk around this axis. Let's this is O by axis. This is O by. Now, what we can do to find the moment of inertia of complete cylinder around OB or Y axis? We can integrate the MIs of such disk from here to there. Let's say the disk R in the form like this. So this comprises a complete cylinder, and a number of disks are a part of the cylinder. So I've got this value of MI of this particular disk. Then complete moment of inertia of this complete whole cylinder will be MI of all this disk around this axis. Okay, this axis is dividing the complete length of the cylinder in L by 2, because this is the midpoint of the cylinder. Okay, so I will take the moment of inertia of all the disk from this point to that point. Okay, now let's say this is the origin, then the distance will be taken as minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. So these are my limit. So let's talk about the MI of cylinder around O by. So this is I equals integration from L by 2 minus L by 2 to plus L by 2 from here to there, and moment of inertia of one disk around the particular axis. This is O by, and its value is this. So this is pi rho r square 1 by 4 r square plus x square and dx. Let's solve this value. I will get for the convenient, I am changing the limit by using the property of definite integration. So I am multiplying by 2 and taking the limit as 0 to maximum limit. Okay, now pi rho and r square are constant, so let's put them ahead of the integration sign. These are 2 pi r square and rho, and rest terms are 1 by 4 r square x square plus x square dx. Let's integrate this expression. I'll get 2 pi r square rho. This is 1 by 4 r square. I am integrating the whole equation with respect to x. So this x square gets x cube over 3 plus here also this is x raised to the power 3 divided by 3. And limits are 0 to L by 2. Okay, sorry, this is not x square here. So integration of this factor will only as x. Okay, so let's put the limit. So I can put in the place of x as L by 2. So this becomes R square L by 2 and 2 for the 8 plus L by 2 whole cube. So this gives me L cube divided by 8 through 24. If I put 0 in place of x, then complete factor will be 0. So I am not writing the two factors. Now you can multiply with this 2 in the bracket. You will get pi r square rho, and that becomes 4, and that becomes 12. Okay. Now I can take ls common from the bracket, and I get pi r square rho and l, and what is the remaining terms? Remaining terms are r by 4, r square by 4 plus l square divided by 12. Okay, now just look at this expression. This is pi r square l. Pi r square l, here the length of the cylinder is l. Suppose that the length of the cylinder is h, then pi r square h gives me the volume of the cylinder. So pi r square times h is the volume of this particular cylinder. And if I multiply the volume with the density, then that is the mass of the particular body, okay? So pi r square l comprises the volume, and it is multiplied with the rho density. So this becomes mass of the cylinder having radius r and length l, okay? So this is the mass of the cylinder. This complete factor gives me the mass of the cylinder. And it is in multiply of r square divided by 4 and plus l square divided by 12. And this is nothing but the required expression, which was mi of cylinder around an axis which is the perpendicular to the length of the cylinder. Okay, if this is a cylinder and I am interested to rotate the cylinder in this way, so the axis around which this cylinder is rotating, it is perpendicular to its length. So mi, whatever the mi of the cylinder around that particular axis, that can be determined numerically by using these two factors. You should have mass, you should have length, you should have r as well, then you can easily find the numerical value of the mi in that particular condition. In the next video, we will look at the mi of the same cylinder around an axis which is along to the length or height of the cylinder. Okay.